She survived the storm at a grocery store with her four children. Her boyfriend was at their home, which was destroyed. He was badly injured. I understand, Jessica, he was just released from the hospital. Tell me his condition this morning. Also tell me how he describes what happened at your house.
Well, he has a fractured leg. He has broken ribs, puncture wounds, cuts, scrapes, bruises all over him. He's pretty banged up, really sore. He said that he heard some loud noises. He didn't even know that there was bad weather in the area. I didn't know either. He heard some loud noises. He walked to the screen door where he had, like, we had a built-in patio on the front porch. He seen the front porch fly up. He said he had just enough time to run, like, right behind him and dive for the couch, and he held onto the couch for dear life. And he said he flew up. Whenever he finally landed, he landed on a tree. And he immediately got up with the adrenaline rush and ran to find his parents, who were in the home next door to us. They had just enough time to dive inside of their bathtub. And he was able to somewhat unbury them. He was able to flag down a truck, and some guys helped him get all the stuff off of his parents so they could get them out safe.
Oh, my. What's the condition of your house at this moment?
It's gone. It's completely gone. I went and looked at it yesterday. It looks splintered. It looks broken. Our house is not there anymore. It's far away from where it used to be.
We have a picture right now, an aerial image of your house and where it was, and you can see it's just simply gone. You have four children, ages 11 to 4 months old.
Yes.
You were lucky enough not to be at home when the storm hit. Do you ever think of
God? I was not there with my children. I went to go get my baby formula. I missed it by just minutes.
What would have happened had you been at home, if you thought about that?
Me and my children would not have survived that. I don't think there's one chance that me and my kids would have survived that.
What's next for you?
There's a lot of people in the community donating clothes, donating food. I work for an awesome company, Bad Boys Bail Bonds in Opelika. They have helped me so much. Right now we're in a hotel for a week. My mom has a GoFundMe page going. I mean, I'm just going to take it one step at a time, and we're going to start over. And I'm just thankful for the lives that were spared.
That's right.
From my family.
You have what's important. You absolutely have what's important at this point.
Right.
Did you have any warning? Was there warning before the storm hit?
My mom told me there were supposed to be bad thunderstorms, possible tornadoes. But, I mean, we hear that quite often whenever, you know, it rains really bad down here. I had no clue what was coming. No clue. I didn't hear sirens or anything. My phone went off right before that. You know, a lot of people don't watch cable anymore. They watch Netflix and stuff. So we didn't know.
Jessica Chandler, we are so glad that you are okay, your children okay, your boyfriend, Thanks. Your parents. Again, you have what's important. Let us know if there's anything we can do to help.
Thank you so much.